Hello, we hope everybody's doing all right. Today we're gonna take a look at building a solar generator, a portable power box that will provide 110, 120 AC. It'll be powered off a 12 volt lithium battery. It'll be portable. We decided to use this Craftsman VersaStack system. We've seen it on YouTube a few times and it was in our local Lowe's on sale. So we went ahead and picked it up. It's pretty lightweight. You can get a few more of their attachments that go up top here. It's got a waterproof lid, little foam insert. Inside it's pretty deep. It's about 19-20 inches at the narrowest part from the wheelbase is in. So your first thing you want to do is decide really your power needs. I mean, you have to be realistic on what you can move and carry. So we decided to go with a DigiMarker battery. It's 135 amp hour, 12.8 volts. It fits really well inside of this VersaStack system back in between the wheels back here. So it was just coincidence that we had the two and we measured and it fit. What we're going to do is we're going to backfill it with some foam board and get everything nice and tight in there because you want to really protect this battery from getting banged around because this thing will be mobile and also from low temperature so you don't freeze the cells. But we're going to get some cutouts in there and we'll be back. All right, we got the battery in there. We're going to glue everything in. We got it surrounded with foam top and bottom, and we got a little wooden shelf cutout to go on top here to support everything else, the electronics and all that. So we'll get everything hooked up and we'll be back. All right, this is what we come up with. This battery can hold a maximum of about 700 watts, so we didn't have an inverter small enough but this one, but we're looking at some closer to 700 now, but this will work for the time being. Everything's encased. We didn't glue anything in yet. We got a shunt there. This has an app and everything that you can view on it. We're gonna get it all set up, get everything going. There's the screen, it's pretty nice. So we'll do a full review on all these things and make sure they're good. But yeah, that's kind of how we're liking it. And it'll close. That thing's gonna fall because it's not glued in. Closes up. Everything's sealed. All right, everyone, at this stage, we are done with the build. It is far from being complete, though. This is just a hasty put-together system. There's no outside ports or anything. We are going to add some outside plugs and things like that so we can keep it closed and out of the weather if there is bad weather. But this is the basic setup here. We have the battery. We have a pocket here for any accessories we want to take, which we will be adding accessories. You'll have to subscribe and stay tuned for additional episodes on this. But we are hooked up here. There we go. We are hooked up here. For right now, we just have it hooked up so that we can take the inverter on and off here, but we will add a switch in there because it does have a slight parasitic draw. Nothing that the shunt's picking up, but eventually over time, this LED light will kill the battery. It'll take a long time though, because this is a 135 amp hour battery. 500 watts. We're missing a fuse here, so we are going to order a fuse. We're gonna see actually what size fuse we need, because this thing is rated at 500 watts, but we're not 100% sure on what it can pull. So we're gonna plug a little heater in and see what we can get. All right, we have the inverter set up with the heater on it. The battery claims to have a 50 amp BMS. That's where they want you to charge it and discharge it right at 50 amps. We're going to see what we can get. That equates to about 640 watts. This is a 500 watt pure sine wave inverter running a small ceramic heater. So one of these little small ceramic guys. So I think this is a 1400 watt heater. All right, we turn the inverter on. The inverter is drawing down about 3 watts. That's just the fan on the heater. Pulling about an amp out of there, 1.2 amps, 16 and a half watts. Now we'll turn the heat on. And now the amperage, they say again is 50, but we'll see how much it can pull. We're already hitting 240 so watts, almost 20 amps. And just to show you, it is running. And blowing hot air out. So we're pulling about 470 watts, 36 amps, 37 amps. It's doing pretty good. All right, we're over 500 watts, 550 watts. So the inverter is doing very well. And all the links will be in the description for this stuff. From the inverter. We're coming up on that 640 mark for the BMS on the battery. 630. All right, we are over 50 amps now out of the battery and over 640 watts. So we need at least at a minimum a 60 amp fuse for the hot side. The inverter might shut off soon as a protection on itself. It's doing very, very well. 710. Cables are just slightly warm on the inverter side, but the battery cables are fine. Almost 58 amps. 724. I got a feeling this thing's gonna cut off soon. Coming up on 730 watts, 58 amps, 58 and a half amps. And that was it. So the inverter tripped and protected itself. And we'll dial back down the heater here. And as you can see, we can reset it. And the wattage comes right back on. So yeah, this thing is done very well. It can sustain 700 watts. Well, we'll say the 640, what the battery says, it could definitely handle no matter what. So we'll see if we can get something and run it up right under 700 watts and see. Let's see what the maximum wattage we can hold is. Over 30 amps DC being pulled out of the battery, 400 watts. right, we're approaching 40 amps DC out of the battery, 500 watts from the inverter. It's doing excellent. Just to show you everything. Everything is being powered from there. Alright, pulling out 41 amps so far. 522 watts, no problem, out of the 500 watt inverter. Alright, no problem for 500 watts. So we could probably put 600 watts out of this inverter, no issues, and still be running good. Alright, as you see, this thing is a pretty powerful little system. It delivers over 700 watts as a gradual increase out of this 500 watt inverter. It pulls well over 500 watts consistently by itself. We have it hooked to a shunt and a battery monitoring system. So basically, this thing is ready to produce power, but it's not complete yet. It's not 100% safe. We got to add a fuse in there. We want to add a disconnect in there. We also have to have a way to charge this thing. This is a pretty big battery at 135 amp hours. So we're going to need to maybe integrate a charger into here, get some solar in here. It's a little bit of a hassle to have to keep opening and closing this to get into the plug, so we may add some external plugs out here. So yeah, stay tuned and follow us for this inverter solar generator build here. This is the cheapest and easiest way to get power wherever you want. Links are in the description. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.